first lesson, right? Peace and harmony and grammar part, degrees of comparison. This is our third class, and in this third class, in our third session, you are going to learn a poem. That's I want peace. I want peace. This poem you are going to learn, and open the textbooks of yours, page number 15. Go to the page number 15. If you open your textbooks, you can see the poem. I'll recite this. We should not say read poem. We should use the word recite. To a lesson, you can say read. But to poem, you should not say reader. You should use a word called recite. Now I'll recite. See, I want peace. Poem. The earth. If the earth has a voice. If the earth, where we are living? On the earth. Is not it? If the earth has voice, you know, how it could speak? How it could speak? And what were the feelings of the earth about the people? You are going to know in this poem. Understood? What you are going to learn in this poem? Now, if the earth has voice, if it could speak, what words will come out from the earth? What words can you hear? Now you are going to learn. Okay? I am big and round. I wonder if there will be peace. I hear the sounds of people who are being killed. I see the people crying for life. I want to help the poor people. So the first stanza, I recite it again. I am big and round. I wonder if there will be peace. I hear the sounds of people who are being killed. I see the people crying for life. I want to help the poor people. The earth, it was talking in such a way that, what was the shape of the earth? What was the shape? It was big and round. So, it was the shape of that. And see here, I feel happy if there will be peace. What is peace? Quietness. No violence, only happiness to all the people. And living in a very calm way. That is peace, right? So, if there will, all the people will be in peace, I feel happy. And also, I hear the people's sounds who are being killed. See, now in this present society, see, murders and a completely criminal news we can hear many. Is not it? So the earth was telling that, see, I can hear the people's sounds who are being killed. I mean, some people, they die with different diseases. See, now we are suffering of corona. Like that, you know, there are number of diseases around us. Many people, some people with due to diseases, some people due to economical problems, some people health issues, some people, you know, mental disability, physical disability, or number of problems, you know, in a way of according to the range they will have the problems. But if there will be a problem, the people will die or whatever the reason might be, you know, when they were dying, you know, when the people are getting killed with it, whatever the reason might be, I can hear the sounds of those people. It was saying it. And also, I see the people crying for life. Some people, you know, to lead their life away, they used to cry. Poor people, you know, how many problems they used to have. One day leading a life, you know, it is difficult for them. Getting food and making their children educated. And also leading life, number of people we can see all over India, all over the world, that they were dying of hunger. No food, no shelter, no education. Number of children we can see in that way. So the earth was listening the sounds of all the people. And I want to help the poor people. So she would like to help the poor people. I am big and round. I feel the weight of sorrow on me. I touch the feelings of the people. I worry about the future of the people on me. I cry for help from God. So it was saying, I am big and round. I can feel the weight of sorrow on me. Completely, you know, the sadness which was filled on the earth. Many people, they were suffering with problems. So, you know, I can feel that sorrow. I can feel the sadness of the people. And I can touch their feelings. Means what? When they were getting the sad like that, you know, when they were suffering like that, that is touching my heart. It is very painful to me, it was telling. and I worried about the future of the people. Why she had to worry? Because what we are going to do? Are we encouraging the nation to grow? No, we are going to dismantle everything. 100% we are going to dismantle it. We are not preferring to live in greenery. Alright? The man was cutting a branch where he was living. Unknowingly, he was doing a damage to himself. So the earth was telling that the man was completely going to collapse everything. He was going to dismantle everything. I'm bothering about that, and that is touching my feelings. That's going to touch my feelings. I'm bothering about that. I cried for help from God. See, the earth was praying to God to help those people. The girl, it was praying to God to help those people. I'm big and wrong. I understand the problems of the people on me. I say grace for all people. I dream about my past. I try to handle my sorrow. I hope I won't be destroyed. I'm big and wrong. So, it was telling that I understand the problems of the people on me. Who don't have problems? Everybody have the problems. You have the problems. I have the problems. Everybody have the problems. Right, children? Right? It's not that even your family will have the problems. Outside people, our neighbors, our relatives, even president and prime minister, and whoever according to their ages, they have their problems. It's not it? So when they were suffering their problems, you know, I can hear the problems of them. I can hear the problems of them, and I can understand the problems of them who are leaning on me. See, on earth who are leaning? We the people who are leaning. We are going to do everything. We are suffering. We are facing the problems. We are facing difficulties. Everything we are experiencing is not it. And I say grace for all people. So she was trying to give grace, goodness, blessings to all the people. She was going to give blessings to all the people. I dreamt about my past. I tried to handle my sorrow. I hope I don't be destroyed. Why the earth was feeling that it was going to be destroyed? Because on earth, if we have felt what we can find, we can see all over the trees, rivers, mountains, everything. But what the man was doing nowadays is, you know, to his technology, to develop technology, to do something, we are going to destroy the nature. So without nature, can it be possible to imagine the earth? Only we the people will live on it. Without any water, without any air, only we the people can be possible. So the man, he was going to destroy the nature. So finally, the earth, what it would like to convey a message to the people? See here, the people who were living on me, they were suffering from many problems. I'm going to understand the pain of them. And that pain is touching my heart. And I could not see all these things. And also it was saying that, I think these things may not be, make me to my destroy. I will destroy. So I could not destroy, it was expecting. I am big and round. See, the poem also had ended. Again, I was big and round. I am big and round. So what was the shape of the earth? Big and round. It will be big and round. It was in the shape of round. It's not it. Like a circle it was. And here the poem had finished. And if you go to the page number 16, you have a lesson, students. You have a lesson in a section C. In the section C, you have a lesson. That is C, Grand Contest in the Forest. Grand Contest in the Forest. This is the last part in our unit 1. Okay, students? Okay? Just go to the page number 16. If you could open the page number 16, you find this lesson. See this picture, all it was showing? An elephant, a peacock, a squirrel. Is not it? You can see the animals in this picture, right? So just don't imagine the story. I could start now telling the story. You can open the textbooks. The animals, birds and trees were excited. They began to prepare for the great day. When they would give the best to the great one except the little grey squirrel. So one day, you know, one evening in the forest, they are going to celebrate an occasion in the forest. They are going to celebrate a festival. Like a festival, there was a contest. It's going to like a competition. Means what? Among all the animals, you know, which animal can give their best? Means it has to prepare something. It should prepare something, and it should present that. Then who will be the guest? The god of wind, the god of air. Okay, all the people, they come like guest, and also one special guest will be a great one. The little gray squirrel, you know, a great one, except the great one, which one prepared by the great one, you know, that gets a honor. It will be identified by all the people. So when the contest was declared in the forest to be held, all the animals are busy in preparing. I get something. They were in busy. But one small squirrel is there. What was the? So it is a small creature now. It was so small. So that squirrel did not understand what to do. All the others were big, you know, they are very busy in getting something. But this was so small now, it could not do anything. So what it has to do? There was excitement in the air. There was going to be a grand contest. So it was a greater contest. Everyone should show something special. And the best one would be praised by the lords of fire, wind, water and sun. The animals and trees began preparations. I will shine like sparkling sunshine, said the laburnum. My flowers will look like golden raindrops, the gulmohar said. I will dress myself so that I look like an early morning sun, golden red, spreading radiance. I will off the best honey I can find, shouted the bear. See, so there was a grand contest in the forest, no? There was a grand contest in the forest. Then who were the guests? Lots of fire, wind, air, water and sun. Lots of fire means god of fire, god of wind, god of water and the sun. They were the guests to the contest. And in the contest, every animal should give the best. It had to show the best. Then all the animals were very busy in preparation. In that, see here, laburnum, a tree with the yellow flowers. It was telling that I will shine like a sun. And now it looked like golden raindrops. That was the specialty of that tree. And Gulmohar, it was saying that it was dressed myself like that morning sun. All the sun used to look like reddish in the morning. So it spread a light of radiance, fully radiance it would like to spread. And also the beaver had told that it could get the best honey in the forest. The elephant said, I will get the best fruit, so fresh it would still be there on the branches, and lay them at her feet. So elephant also, it would like to bring some fresh fruits. How fresh, you know, from the tree, if you pick and if you get, how fresh it used to be, like that fresh fruits I could bring. Everyone had something beautiful or wonderful to offer on the great day. So everyone, Gulmohar, auntie, elephant, everybody had their own speciality. Even trees also were making preparation. Trees also were making preparation. And right, and also see here, remaining all the animals, when they were in busy, when they were going to make an arrangement of it, then suddenly a small squirrel, it was talking himself. What does a little grey squirrel with black stripes have to offer? So, see, a small squirrel, what it can get on the special great contest and a great day, what it can get, it was thinking. The polish said, a tree. What is mean by polish? A tree. The forest will be ablaze with my beauty, thought late. I will save some flowers. So, actually, what it had speciality? It shines. It shines with its flowers. So even that was making arrangement of that. And through Ellie, I will make some flowers bloom. Snap with the gulmohar. So again, gulmohar had also speciality of flowers. The beautiful trees and creatures had started competing and fighting. So they were in a competition mood. See, competition will be like a competition mood. See, the lots of wind, water and fire and also the sun were the guests. And also they will deserve the best. Who performs the best, who gets the best, for them, you know, they used to give a, in a contest, they used to get a prize. So all the trees were busy, all the animals were busy by making their arrangements to give the best to them. But small spirit, what it can do, what it can get, it started thinking. My mangoes are ready, announced the mango tree. Mango tree also is ready with mango fruits. And the peacock said, emeralds and turquoises are my feathers. So it had a beautiful feathers now. It had beautiful feathers now. The feathers looks very beautiful. So it used to present them, feathers only. And the lark trilled, I will sing a song beautiful and moving. The dove cooed, saying that great one would love her soft notes. Actually, even though the birds also were ready to make their noises, to with their singing, you know, they would like to impress the guest. The guests who were coming, you know, with their voices, they would like to impress them. Gifts and beauty abound, thought the squirrel in despair. He thought and thought, but I will do what I can do best. So the squirrel, it thought, even though trees were busy and the birds were busy and the animals were busy, everybody was trying to give their best. Then what I could do, it started thinking. So finally it decided, what I had, that only I can do. He found hollow branches and filled them with as many nuts and seeds of different trees as he could find. So what it did, you know, definitely there will be holes to the trees, right? There will be holes to the trees. That complete holes, it filled with nuts. There were holes, right, to the trees. That holes, it filled with the nuts. The next day, everyone was ready. Okay, the grand one came, the great one came. Everyone, the contest was ready and all the people had come. And all the animals, trees, everybody, it had started. The air became soft and balmy and the streams twinkled as they tumbled over little rocks. Great one, here is my gift, say each, laying gifts at her feet. After everyone had given their gifts, the great one looked at the little gray squirrel and asked the little one, why are you quiet? So see children, if you look the picture over here, she was the great one. She was the great one. So all the animals, they were near to her and they brought the things. Right? They decided, no, peacock gives the feathers and the mango tree gives mangoes and the deer will get honey and elephant fruits. All they had performed except the squirrel. Then the great one asked, come on squirrel, why are you quiet and what did you bring? And the great one, here is my gift, said each, laying gifts at her feet. After everyone had given, at last, the grey squirrel had asked the little one, why are you quiet? I have nothing grand to offer you. I don't glow or see, but I give with my heart, and scampered away. He returned dragging in dry branches. The great one looked grave. I see beauty in form and sound. All waited holding their breath. But the prize goes to the grey squirrel, and I can use the seeds to sow them. New life will burst forth. Trees will bear more fruit. It is a gift not only for today, but also for all our tomorrows. The creatures then marvel, saying, how foolish we were thinking the only of the present. Three cheers for the little squirrel. So, what all the animals, they brought fresh things, right? Except the squirrel. Then the great one asked, come on squirrel, what did you bring? Then it had, what it had in squirrel? What, it prepared anything? No, it filled the holes of the tree with the seeds. Then great one had appreciated the squirrel and it gained a great contest. The prize had gone to the squirrel only. Why the prize had gone to the squirrel? Because squirrel had did a small thing only. But when it was saying the seeds, when it was saving the seeds, that seeds will help for the future generations. If they put the seeds, they will grow trees and they give us fruits, they give us nuts. So these nuts, when it had hold it, when it saved in the holes, you know, they help for the future generations. All the animals, they thought only for the present situation, present day contest, how we should keep competition, how we should keep competition, they thought, but they did not think about future. Only small creature, see, squirrel only it had thought. So who was the winner of the contest? Our small squirrel. So children, what work you do, it is not important, small or bigger. It may be a small work, but that small work should help other students. So here all animals, they did many, many big things, but they did not get identification because they gave competition, but they did not think of future. But even though the squirrel is very small, even though it was very small, it thought about our future generations. It saved all the nuts in the hole and it saved our future. So that's why in the grand contest, the winner was our squirrel. Okay? Work may be small or big, but it should give a good result to others. It should help others. Then only we get identification. This is the moral of the lesson. Our lesson had come to an end. And what is your homework, you know? Here, you have a glossary. And also, there, I told you the poem the first of before the lesson. Before the explanation of the lesson, I told a poem in page number 50. I want peace. Is not it? I told a poem. I recited a poem. That poem, you should write one time. Neatly, stanza, stanza. But following all the capital letters where it had come, with a neat handwriting, you should write it one time. This is your homework. So, note down your homework. So this is your homework, students, and we have come to the end of our unit 1. We have finished our unit 1 and we are going to meet with our unit 2 in our next class. See you in our next class. Thank you.